Hi there, welcome to my YouTube channel. So ESG stocks, so those stocks which actually contribute to the environment, to the social fabric of our society and on governance. So I've spoken about in detail about ESG stocks a few weeks ago. So today I thought I'll talk about the five top ESG stocks that you could invest in. In my video yesterday, I had spoken about the top stocks, five stocks that you could invest in, and all five of them were tech stocks. But today I thought I'll talk about ESG primarily because a lot of companies are moving in that direction, including the tech companies. So it is quite relevant, and as an investor, you should concentrate on this consider stocks who are companies which invest in ESG. So I'm going to talk about all of that today. As usual, before I start, please like my videos, please subscribe to my channel, please smash that notification bell so that you get informed every time I upload a new video. Please comment on my video so that I know what exactly you're looking at and I can craft out a video based on your requirement. Please share my videos with people who you think would benefit from my research, from my knowledge, and from my videos. So without further ado, let's dive in. So first, before I start, I talk about my ebook. Now, this ebook is on my journey as an entrepreneur. It's titled Six-Figure Corporate Job to Master Entrepreneurs. Now, in this ebook, I've spoken about the time back in 2010 when I quit my six-figure globetrotting corporate job. It starts with my preparation before I actually quit my job and jumped in. It talks about the challenges I faced and also talks about how I overcame those challenges. Now, I'm quite sure that a lot of you would be looking to becoming an entrepreneur, especially those who are in full-time day jobs. And with that in mind, I put down three worksheets in this ebook, essentially to gauge your frame of mind, to check how prepared you are to becoming an entrepreneur. Now you have to, there in those worksheets, you have to answer certain questions, get points or score points, and towards the end, you would see where you stand in terms of your preparedness. I have also taken those tests or those worksheets I've answered based on my mindset back in 2010. You will get to know how much I scored. You will also know how successful I am today as an entrepreneur with two companies, one in Singapore, the other one in India, and representations in the US market. Now, the coolest thing is that this ebook comes to you for free of charge. It's available on my website. The URL is flashing on the screen now. I'll put the URL in the description box below. Click on the URL, go to the page, put down your name and email address, and the link to download the ebook will be emailed to your inbox. I hope you like the ebook. Do give me your honest feedback. Now let's talk about the five ESG stocks. First stock is NextEra. NextEra is the largest electric utility by market cap. Over the last few decades, the company has been consistently reducing the emission through increased renewable energy use. Its CO2 emissions are 55% less than those in average U.S. utility. NextEra has new set of ambitious goals of reducing CO2 emission by 2025 by 67% from its 2005 base levels. This goal effectively means that absolute CO2 emission would go down by 40% even while NextEra's energy production would double during that time. To its credit, the company last year received a best-in-class preparedness assessment by S&P Global Ratings ESG evaluation. NextEra has essentially received the highest ranking given by S&P to a company within the utility sector. Second company is NVIDIA. NVIDIA is well known for making graphic cards. We all know that. And also for supplying chips to cryptocurrency miners. Minerals are something that NVIDIA uses extensively for its chips and parts. Thus, NVIDIA is closely linked to environmental and social issues related to mining. NVIDIA is a highly rated ESG company. It's a highly rated ESG company because it has a stringent policy regarding conflict minerals. The company has a specific due diligence procedures to ensure that it never uses conflict minerals in its products. The company is also big on the governance aspect as it trains nearly 100% of its customers, suppliers, partners facing workforce for anti-corruption and anti-bribery. So there's the environment and governance as well as social element concept. Third company is Hansen. This is a Danish company. Christian Hansen is a Danish bioscience company that operates in the human nutrition space. It specializes in producing bacteria that reduce pesticide usage, increase crop yield, and curb food wastage. From a sustainability standpoint, improving food security and reducing waste are essential milestones. Therefore, the company's business model is inherently ESG friendly. The company has also deployed a unique accounting system that measures the impact of its products against the UN's Sustainable Development Goals. No wonder Christian Hansen is the number one ranked company on the Corporate Knights Global 100 most sustainable corporation in the world list. Fourth, Microsoft. Now, Microsoft has taken the lead in its commitment towards carbon mitigation by becoming the first company amongst its peers to target carbon negative status by 2030. It has created a $1 billion fund to reduce emission and start clearing carbon. This ambitious commitment is unprecedented and sets Microsoft apart from its entire sector. Microsoft received the highest ESG rating of AAA from MSCI ESG Research in September 2019. Fourth and last company, of course, this is Home Depot. As the largest home improvement retailer in the US, Home Depot tends to deal with multiple wood-based products. However, the company has a strict sourcing policy that prevents the purchase of conflict material minerals and exploits the natural resources of developing countries. Home Depot has plans to reduce their emission by 40% by 2030 and 50% by 2035. Another big goal is to help Home Depot consumers reduce their water consumption by 250 billion gallons. There are a total of 7 focus areas on which the company is working to becoming a sustainable and responsible enterprise. So those are the 5 ESG stocks that I wanted to talk to you about. These are the top stocks, at least at this point in time. Please go ahead and invest in these if you are looking to invest in the ESG sector. There are more stocks that I could talk about. There are about, I could rattle out another 10 names in the ESG sector, which are also doing well. But at this particular moment, these are the number top 5. So the conclusion is ESG stocks are really great options for investors to invest in because they're really looking at the environment, they're looking at governance, they're looking at social issues around the world. So I would really ask people to go ahead and invest in ESG stocks, and these are the top ones that you could look out for. I would also direct you to the video I did on ESG stocks a few days ago. I actually did a few of them, 2 or 3 videos. I'll direct you to the first video, which essentially talks about ESG. And then you could go and look for other videos on ESG as well. So I'll put the link to that video on the card above. I'm sure that if you are not familiar with ESG, that will be useful to you. Finally, thank you very much for listening to me. As you know, my name is Saurav Mukherjee. I'm a digital and technology marketing leader with over 10 years of global experience. I'll put down the URL to my LinkedIn in the description box below. Click on it, go to the page. Take a look at my profile. If you like it, send me an invite. I regularly work with clients where I try and solve their business, marketing, technological investment challenges. If you're looking to engage me as a consultant in your company, you could just drop me a line on LinkedIn, or you could write to me on the contact page of my website. I'll put on the contact page of my website URL in the description box below. Then we can communicate and see how we can work together. So lastly, before I go, please like my videos, please subscribe to my channel, please smash that notification bell, please comment on my videos, and please share my videos. So until next time, stay safe and stay healthy, and I shall see you soon. Bye-bye.